Today, we'll take a look at how you can easily animate video clips, still images, icons, titles, and more without a single keyframe using the FCPX Animation Megapack plugin from Pixel Film Studios. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge and welcome back to my channel. In this video, we'll be taking a look at the FCPX Animation Megapack plugin from Pixel Film Studios. This plugin features over 300 unique tools and over 30,000 animations to choose from. You can use it to animate single clips, images or graphics, use a combination of the effects to put together video intros, photo slideshows, logo reveals and more, and even use these effects to transition between clips. Let's jump into Final Cut Pro and take a look how you can use the effects included in this plugin to make better videos. After installing the plugins included in this Megapack, you'll find the effects from Pro Animation and Pro Animation 2.0 in your Titles browser, an additional Megapack effects in the Titles browser and the Effects browser. To preview these animations, simply skim over one of the presets in the Media browser. First, let's take a look at the basics and use this plugin to animate in and out a simple video clip. Place your skimmer about 1 second into your clip and press Command B to blade it. In the Effects browser, select the FCPX Animation Megapack, choose your animation preset, and drag and drop it over the first part of the clip. This is what the default animation looks like. But if you head up to the Video Inspector, you'll see quite a few controls you can customize there. Since this is at the start of the clip, we'll leave the animation type to Animate In. The Animation Selection dropdown lets you adjust the timing of your animation. Let's change ours to Fast In, Slow Out. The Animation Strength slider adjusts when your animation starts and ends, and you can also flip the animation by using this checkbox. Under this, you have controls to adjust motion blur, and also the transform parameters. Play with this until you get it looking just the way you want. Animating a clip out is very similar. Place your skimmer where you want to start, and press Command B to blade your clip. Add your chosen preset to the last part of your clip, change the animation type to Animate Out, and adjust your parameters. This is how simple it is to animate your clips without having to use a single keyframe. Next, let's take a look at how you can use a combination of these presets to make a custom video intro. But before we do, let's take a minute to talk about the sponsor of this video, Pixel Film Studios. Besides making a lot of cool and useful plugins for Final Cut Pro, Pixel Film Studios is also a great resource for training. They have a playlist with over 200 free tutorials, all focused on Final Cut Pro. Whether you're just starting out and want to learn the basics, or need to learn a specific feature or effect, chances are this playlist has a tutorial for you. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. Now back to Final Cut Pro. We'll start off with a dynamic background for our intro. To make things simple, let's just use one of Final Cut Pro's built-in background generators. Next, to make it less boring, we'll animate this in and out. Select the Pro Animation 2 plugin and skim over some of the presets. Once you find the one you like, with your playhead at the start of your clip, press Q to connect this adjustment layer to your clip. This animation will be applied to everything under our adjustment layer, which at the time is only the generator clip. Next, scroll down to the Animate Out category and select a preset for your out animation. Move your playhead to the end of your clip, hold down the Shift key, and press Q to perform a backtime connect edit. This will align the adjustment layer's endpoint to the playhead. Now, with our background layer animated, let's bring in our logo and some text. Place a playhead a few frames before the end of the first adjustment layer, press Command 1 to go to the Media browser, select your logo you want to add, and press Q to connect it to your timeline. Move your skimmer to the start of your second adjustment layer, and with the connected clip selected, press Option and right bracket to trim the end of your connected clip to the skimmer. Press Shift T to select the Transform tool, reposition your logo to the left side of the screen, and adjust the size. Press Enter to deactivate the Transform tool. Press Option Command 1 to go back to the Titles browser, select the Pro Animation plugin, and locate the Spring Master adjustment layer in the Animate In category. Add this above the connected clip in your timeline. This is a master adjustment layer that all the included presets are based on. It gives you full control of any animations in the inspector window. Scroll down to the animation controls and select the type of animation you want to add to this logo. First, let's set the direction to front animation number 1. If you skim over the clip, you'll notice the adjustment layer not only affects the logo under it, but also the generator clip below that. I'll show you how to deal with that a little later in the video. For now, just select the generator clip and press V to disable it. Select the adjustment layer again and adjust the parameters in the inspector until you have it looking the way you want. Once done, skim over your clip until you get to the end of the animation and press Option and right bracket key to trim the end of this adjustment layer to your skimmer. Next, let's add some text to our intro by adding a title. For this demo, we'll have three lines of text and stagger them on screen. So once you adjust the appearance of your title, make two more copies of it. Adjust the text and position and stagger these clips about 10 frames apart. For the out animation, we want the text to go with the logo, and since adjustment layers affect every clip under them, all we have to do is add an animation preset as the top layer at the end. And last, to add a bit of motion to the entire thing, select the through animation, place it as your top layer, and ripple trim it to the same length as your clips. This is what we have. But look at what happens when we re-enable our bottom layer. All the adjustment layers we added to the logo and text layers also affect your generator clip. To fix this, select your logo and text clips and all the adjustment layers applied to them and combine them into a compound clip by pressing Option G. Here's our finished result, all done without using a single keyframe. If this plugin is something you're interested in, during checkout, use the coupon code SurgePixel for 30% off your purchase, limited to the first 500 users. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.